About 15 years ago, someone working for action movie mega producer Jerry Bruckheimer, or maybe it was Jerry Bruckheimer himself, who knows, had a crazy idea. What if they made a couple of their signature big, loud, violent, ultra-macho action movies, but instead of casting the usual muscle man or martial artist or even a plausible hard-ass as the hero, they went and used one of those wacky, unpredictable, possibly insane indie movie type guys. You know, somebody like Nicolas Cage. I don't know if I can convey to you just how weird an idea this was at the time if you weren't old enough to have known of Nicolas Cage beforehand, but imagine if you found out tomorrow that Sarah Silverman was going to play Wonder Woman. That times about 100. Turned out to be a good idea, though. The Rock and Con Air were huge hits that overnight transformed Nicolas Cage from an offbeat oddball, best known for comic book collecting and a series of acclaimed batshit crazy scenery-chewing performances in edgy stuff like Leaving Las Vegas and Raising Arizona, into an improbable blockbuster action hero. And you can probably credit this phenomenon with all the other outside-the-box casting inspiration as late, like Johnny Depp as a pirate, Jake Gyllenhaal as the Prince of Persia, or Michael Cera as anything. And say what you will about some of Cage's recent movies, just think how boring National Treasure, Next, or Ghost Rider would have been without his over-the-top craziness presiding over them. Trouble is always the case with out-there actors, they can be hard to manage. It takes a certain kind of brilliance to point over the top in the direction of something slightly more. Enter legendary filmmaker Werner Herzog. He directed the movies that made Klaus Kinski a star, so you'd better believe he knows what to do with a unique talent like Cage's, and a great vehicle like an in-name-only remake of Bad Lieutenant, a massively overrated Abel Ferreira entry best remembered for Harvey Keitel's landmark turn as a singularly evil officer of the NYPD. Bad Lieutenant Port of Call New Orleans shifts things to post-Hurricane Katrina, Louisiana, and follows Cage as Terrence McDonough, a police detective who's violent, hateful, scheming, and wholly corrupt even before he starts in on the massive doses of booze, coke, crack, heroin, prescription, and all the other crap he's flying high on for most of the movie. There's no depth of madness or depravity this guy won't sink to, torturing wheelchair-bound old ladies for information, hallucinating phantom iguanas, stealing drugs from teenage girls he arrests, and then more or less raping them while forcing their dates to watch at gunpoint. He's a sick, sad bastard on a downward spiral, using his power as a cop to do whatever he wants to whoever he wants, including himself. And this is the good guy, or at least the protagonist, because even with all that other stuff, there's still technically a crime to be solved, and he's still technically a cop. Thus, the film appears to reveal itself as something close to a genre spoof, a brutal satire of formula American cop movies by way of inserting the Bad Lieutenant into all the classic overused scenarios. Think of a cheesy cop movie cliche, and it's in here. Precocious child witness? Check. Hooker with a heart of gold? Check. Gambling problem? Check. Complex relationship with alcoholic dad? Check. Big slobbery dog? Check. Green partners learning the ropes? You bet your ass that's a check. It's the greatest hits of every bastard child of Dirty Harry and Lethal Weapon, as seen through the eyes of an unhinged madman all too aware that the countdown to everyone else realizing exactly what he really is just about up. Or is it? Look, only Nicolas Cage could have played this part this way, and only Werner Herzog could have fitted into an actual movie. Now, the cast is full of great supporting work. There's a gloriously slimy turn by Val Kilmer. There's shattering sexiness from Firouza Balk. There's a great little bit with Brad Dourif, whom you might remember as Grima Wormtongue in Lord of the Rings, or as the voice of Chucky. There's even some menacing stuff from Exhibit as the bad guy who makes the deadly mistake of confusing crazy with stupid when it comes to McDonough. And Eva Mendes is actually better in this than she's been in anything. Ever. But in the end, this is a duet, a perfect pairing of actor and director going all in on a project that seems tailor-made for their unique skill sets. What other movie star would act opposite his own imaginary iguanas? And what other director would ask him to? If Bad Lieutenant Port of Call New Orleans is playing near you, I recommend you go give it a look. I can't promise that you'll like it. Hell no. In fact, lots of people are gonna hate it. It's one of those movies that's hard to judge, since it seems to come from another universe entirely different from our own, and thus not fit to conventional models of critic or review. But I can promise that you'll remember it. for good or ill, you will not believe some of the stuff you see here. And it's going to get in your skull and sit there, daring you to think about it again. And that's something you can't really say for a lot of the crap clogging up the multiplex right now. Believe me, I've had to watch all of it. See you next time.
Shoot him again.
What?
Fool. His soul's still dancing.